And welcome everybody to first quarter action, game 7. Monmouth College in the white caps, Conn College in the dark caps. And we got our first goal of the game for Monmouth. It's number 11, Jared Hankinson, a senior from St. Louis. And the Fighting Scots, they score first, 1-0 early on here in the first quarter. This free stream presented by Cap 7 and the CWPA. I'm Mike Shannon for CWPA TV. Got three games for you this morning, running on hour and 20 minute increments. So our next game up is 11:20 a.m., following that 12:40 p.m. A power play opportunity for the Camels. Skip shot, save made in goal. Now moving on in transition, the shot and goal between two defenders. That was good patience and good execution there. Number 20, Joseph Addison. Just a freshman. Giving his team an early 2-goal lead. Ordinary foul. So corner throw, heavy defense, trying to turn around, shot and goal. Thought that might have hit the side of the cage, but found enough room to put it in the back of the cage. That's number 21, Christian Jacobson. So the Camels get a goal back of their own. Cut the Fighting Scot lead in half early on here in the first. Good save made by Tanner McKellis. Outlet pass along the far side. Ordinary foul. Looking to go to the center. And I believe we're going to have an exclusion. Quick shot. And that one's going to go high above the crossbar. Now looking to get going. Good job stopping that transition by the Camels. Unable to come away with anything on that possession. On the near side. Then we're going to get an offensive foul called. And we're going to have an exclusion on the play. It's a power play opportunity coming up for the Fighting Scots, looking to get that 2-goal lead back. Good ball movement. Rising up, shot. Save made by Tanner McKellis and chased down by the Camels.
Okay.
Now walking it in. Ordinary foul. Up top. Shot. Save made with the right arm. Kyle Jones in cage for the Fighting Scots. Made a couple very nice saves yesterday. Another exclusion. It's a very physical game so far. And we got another exclusion. So two-man advantage almost at the exact same time. A lot of time here is going to be, yeah, look at just walking it in. Just patient. Trying to find that shot. Near side, there it is. Goal scored, and that's what patience does. It allows you to find openings in the defense. Goal scored from number 7. That's Quinton Bartram. So three different Monmouth players scoring so far in this first quarter. That goal just by Quinton Bartram. Other goal scorers, number 11, Jared Hankinson, and number 20, Joseph Addison. Lone goal scorer for Conn College so far is number 21, Christian Jacobson. And can't say that anymore. Just as I say that, goal scored. Nope, maybe I still can say that. Goal scored by number 21, Christian Jacobson. It's his second of the game. Able to get the lead for Monmouth back down to 1. So we got some good action so far this morning in this first quarter. Save made. Good job by Kyle Jones, getting real big there. Now long outlet pass. Had good positioning, but that was a good defensive play. And it looks like they're still going to give the ball to Monmouth here. But that was good defense, making sure that that positioning that he gave up wasn't detrimental. And able to come away with a defensive stand here. Goal scored for Connecticut College. Able to tie this one up. That one scored by number 10, Arturo Freitas. Able to tie this one up for his team. Ordinary foul called against the Camels. Looking for the center. Has possession. Turnaround shot. Save made originally by McKellis, and it does not cross the plane. So good recovery from Tanner McKellis. Looking for that redirect. And they get it. Goal scored by number 21, who else but Christian Jacobson. So Conn College putting on a good showing here in the first quarter. Just a tick under 140 to play here. 4-3 is the score. head coach for the Fighting Scots of Monmouth College is Peter Ollis, assistant coach Tom Burek, and the head coach for Connecticut College is Matt Anderson. And our officials for this weekend, head official Bruce Morehouse, and officials Igor Murnenko and Chad Packer, always doing the best work. They were plenty busy in this first quarter, had a couple exclusions, really against Connecticut College. The Fighting Scots picking up a couple as well. So very physical gameplay so far. 4-3, Conn College on top of Monmouth, fresh out of the timeout. About 1:30 to play in the first quarter. Close range shot and goal. They tie it up. All knotted at 4. That's number 21, Jesus Aguirre. Able to tie it up for his team. Got another exclusion called against Monmouth. It's a power play opportunity for the Camels. See if they can cash in, get that lead back. Good ball movement, shot off the goalie, off the crossbar, and kicks back out. Now far side in the corner, redirect and goal for the Camels. Answering Monmouth right back. That goal once again scored by number 21, Christian Jacobson. Really dominating this first quarter. He's got 4 goals so far. Shot, save made. Looks like Kyle Jones really didn't know where that ball went after made contact with him in the post. But fortunately enough for Monmouth, stayed out of the cage. Long shot was corralled in. And at the buzzer, does not go. So, that'll bring us to the end of the first quarter. A score at the end of 8 minutes of play. Conn College 5. Monmouth 4. You're watching Mid-Atlantic Water Polo Conference West Region, CWPATV.com. We'll be right back with second quarter action right after this.
The Cap 7 Head Guard. This product was designed specifically to reduce the risk. You can't prevent a concussion, but you can definitely reduce the impact by wearing a Cap 7 head guard. The most important thing when you look at this cap specifically is the dimples. This has been tested by University of California, Irvine, and been proven to reduce impact by 25%. To put the cap on specifically, you have to have your hair wet. Okay, it's just like putting on any sort of swim cap. So I want to hook it in on the front of my head and then pull it down around. Goes on really quickly and easily. If you try to put it on with dry hair, you're likely to pull your hair out and you're likely to rip the head guard. Now, depending on the cap you have, I recommend doing this in front of a mirror, but as you see again, hooking in on the front first, and even without a mirror, I can just feel around and slap the cap right on. I highly, highly recommend this for any full contact drills during practice, it's the no-brainer when it comes to reducing the risk. Cap 7 head guards, check it out at cap7.com.
Cap 7 is a small company that started out of the back of our garages, and we were doing clinics and camps around the country. We pride ourselves as a company with Cap 7 and Turbo to sponsor as much and give back to the sport as much as we can. Last year, we gave over $250,000 back to the sport, and all our products are built by water polo players and for water polo players.
Hi, I'm Wolf Weigo. Come be my friend on Facebook Live. Check us out.
Thank you.
And sorry about that, folks. We're back. A little bit of technical difficulties. Had two straight goals scored by Monmouth, so they've retaken the lead. Only momentarily, as a goal scored for Connecticut College. That was number 17, Sean King. So Conn College working on the far side, coming back to the near side. In close shot, save made by Kyle Jones. Had some help from his defenders there, but really coming up big. Side in the corner. I believe we'll have an ordinary foul. Yep. Oh, and that one save made by the post and Kyle Jones. And we got a Monmouth goal scored by number 6, Kaveh Moadeli. Gives his team the lead once more. 7-6, waning minutes of the second quarter. Ooh, that was a good pass to the center. Well, it looks like the save was made by Kyle Jones. It's a corner throw coming up for the Camels. Pass inside to the center. Whistle's blown. Exclusion on the play. Power play opportunity for the Camels. Good save made by Kyle Jones. Looks like that one got away from him. Kyle Jones has it. Long outlet pass down the near side. Ordinary foul called. Looking to pass towards the middle. That one's intercepted. And a timeout is going to be called by Connecticut College. With just a shade under a buck 30 to play, it's 7-6. Monmouth on top of Connecticut College. Step aside real quick as they talk it over. We'll be right back right after this.
Cap 7 Water Polo Hydro Splash Ball is the best skip ball for any kid in America. Anyone going on vacation near the ocean or the pool should get one of these for their kids. You won't regret it. Get your Hydro Splash Ball at cap7.com. Cap 7, the official ball of Len. Built by water polo players for water polo players.
Just about to get underway here out of the timeout. Score 7-6, Monmouth on top of Connecticut College. On the campus of Washington and Jefferson College. Take a quick second here. Thank Nikola Melezinov from Washington and Jefferson College, the head coach, helping to organize this stream for us today, as well as our camera operators, Dustin and Austin. And also want to give a shout out to Ed Haas from the CWPA for helping put together all the graphics packages for us this weekend and helping to organize the stream as well. So thank you to him. I'm Mike Shannon for CWPA TV. And we are back in action in the pool at Washington and Jefferson College, 7-6, 1:20 left in the second quarter. Swinging the ball around up top, trying to walk it in. That shot's going to go high. Nobody touched it, so come back to Monmouth. Under a minute to play. Heavy pressure from the Fighting Scots. See, the Fighting Scots are not allowing that center position to get the ball. It doesn't matter. Goal scored for Conn College. Goal scored by number 17, Sean King. His second goal of the game, second goal of the quarter. And that'll bring us to the end of the second quarter. So it's all tied up after two. We're going to halftime. We'll be right back with second half action in Washington and Jefferson College right after this.
At Cap 7, we've been able to grow a lot since 2004. You know, we started out really small as can be, you know, working out of our home, our garage, storing stuff and carports. And, you know, cash flow is always an issue with a new company, and we've been slowly been able to get to a point where we're giving hundreds of thousands of dollars away to different conferences, leagues, sections, CIF sections, and really being able to support the program. And it's been pretty cool to see that progress. And every year we're constantly trying to do more, support more programs, get all over the country, and now moving towards, you know, sponsoring water polo all over the world. So when we founded Cap 7, you know, there were a few water polo companies out there, but wasn't too much. But none of them were ever really doing anything to help the sport or give it back. They were growing, but never giving back. And when we started our company, we wanted to make sure that, you know, if we got bigger along the way, that we would definitely be doing that. And we started that from day one. So, you know, if you're considering, why should I buy from Cap 7 versus X, Y, and Z company? You know, we're former players. Everyone in our company is involved with water polo in one way or another. So if you're considering making a purchase in the sport of water polo, you know, we'd love to think that you can support a company that is supporting you. We're constantly giving back to the sports, sponsoring tournaments, leagues, CIF sections, college teams. We're always giving back. And if you can support us, we'll continue to support you. We'll continue to help push the sport along, continue to advocate for better rules, for all kinds of things that really is going to take our sport to the next level. And that's something we're always thinking about and pushing for. We're not just trying to sell a bulk amount of suits and caps or balls. That's really not what it's about. It's about making better products and helping give back to the sport and take it to the next level.
Yeah, when we're developing any product, for our company specifically, the first, number one is, can we use it and does it pass the test of will it last in a harsh environment? And then once we back into that, then we go out and we source it the best way possible so that we can bring it to market, at a fair price so that you guys have the opportunity to use these training aids that will take your game to the next level. You know, for us specifically, there's products that we're always trying to develop and create new ways to help all of us get better. And so ultimately, like Wolf said, we want to, have an opportunity to provide products to you and support what you're doing. And if you support us, then everything works really well.
Cap 7, built by water polo players for water polo players.
And welcome back, everybody. Just a reminder, coming up at 11:20 a.m. Eastern Time, Salem. They will take on the Golden Knights of Gannon University. That are game 2 of 3 today. Our third game, technically game 9 of the entire weekend, 12:40 p.m. Eastern Time. Washington and Jefferson, the hosts, they take on Mercyhurst. And we're underway here in quarter number 3, second half just underway. Washington and Jefferson College, Conn College 7, Monmouth 7. And we got a goal scored for Monmouth. That's number 2, Eli Kebschel. So Monmouth scoring first. We have an opportunity here for Connecticut College to get that goal right back. And they do. Off the 5-meter penalty shot. Goal scored for number 17, Sean King. His third goal of the game. All tied up once more. It's going to stay down this end with Monmouth. Now playing the middle is broken up due to in part by Tanner McKellis. Some great defensive play as well, smothering that play deep in the offensive zone for Monmouth. Rising up for a shot and a goal for Connecticut College. It's number 21, Christian Jacobson. His first goal since the first quarter, where he absolutely lit it up. It's his fifth goal of the game. Now the Fighting Scots find themselves trailing by one. Now near side, lefty shot, save made after the exclusion was called. Now back the other end. Long pass down the other end of the tank. Still fighting for it. And Conn College comes away with it. Right back down the other end. Ordinary foul. Crossing pass, shot. And it's going to go back to the Fighting Scots. Monmouth in the white caps. Connecticut College in the dark caps. Monmouth moving left to right on your screen. Connecticut College right to left. As the defense is able to take this one away from Monmouth. And we're going to have an offensive foul called against the Camels. So giving the ball right back to the Fighting Scots. Near side. Shot from the point. Blocked by the defense. Before it was able to get to McKellis. Now he fires it back down the other end. They have the advantage. Goal scored for Connecticut College. That's number 10, Arturo Freitas. Scored Connecticut College 10 and Monmouth 8. So Connecticut College coming out swinging in this third quarter. Leading goal scorer for Connecticut College is number 21, Christian Jacobson. He's got 5 goals in the game for them. 3 goals as well scored by number 17, Sean King. 2 goals scored by number 10, Arturo Freitas. And a goal scored for Monmouth. They get one right back out of the timeout. That goal scored by number 21, Jesus Aguirre. His second goal of the game. So Monmouth had an answer. See if Connecticut College can get that one right back. We have an exclusion called on the far side of the pool. So a power play opportunity coming up for the Camels. Shot and goal. Open net on the near side, able to cash it in. Goal scored for number 12, Mike Gertzik. His first goal of the game. And Connecticut College jumps out to a two-goal lead once again. It's been a very back-and-forth game so far. Got just about under 3 minutes, I believe, left to play in this third quarter. Short pass. Trying to walk this one in. Pass far side. Shot and goal. Monmouth answers once again. That goal scored by number 20, Joseph Addison. Second goal of the game. Offensive foul called. He head back the other way. Long outlet pass down the far side. Ordinary foul. Shot. Save made by Kyle Jones. That looks like he's going to get an offensive foul. So back to the Camels. Near side, shot and goal. Sneaks it by Kyle Jones on the near side. Gets it underneath the right arm. That goal scored by number 12, Mike Gertzik. Second goal of the quarter for him. And Connecticut College back up to a two-goal lead. So on the power play here, Fighting Scots looking for an opening. They have a near side. Cross tank pass. Trying to walk it in a little. Near side again. Shot off the crossbar. It's going to ricochet out of play. Very unfortunate. It's just hit the edge of the pool. Now it looks like the officials are going to actually talk it over and try to get the correct call here. So they're going to say it's going to stay with Monmouth. It's a good job by the officials getting together there, conferencing and trying to get the correct call. So Fighting Scots. And the power play comes to the end. Shot goes off of Jones off the post, and now it's a race for the ball on the far side. Connecticut College gets there. It's going to be awarded to the Camels. Skip's shot goes off of Jones and skips above the crossbar and out of play, so stays with Connecticut College. That shot goes above the crossbar, and it'll go back to the Fighting Scots of Monmouth. Pass far side. Ordinary foul. Shot from the point off the post. And Monmouth will easily take this one in. Shot and goal. For the Fighting Scots. Got it to the center. And Jesus Aguirre was able to put it home. His second goal of the third quarter. Third of the game. Brings the Camel lead back down to one. Cross tank pass. Heavy defense. Camels still have it. Going back across the other side. And just looking to dump that one in the corner. Going back to Monmouth. And a goal for the Fighting Scots. They tie it up. It's number 7, Quentin Bartram. Scored a goal in each quarter so far. So, at the end of three quarters, the score, Connecticut College 12, Monmouth 12. We'll be right back with the fourth and final quarter of Game 7, right after this.
Sip me up like lemonade, we both know it's bittersweet. This sourness will bite your tongue, no one is forever young.
Hi, I'm Wolf Weigo, three-time Olympian in water polo and PSAL Swimmer of the Decade. I'd like to just talk about the Safe Lane swim device. It's really a no-brainer. It blows up, you put it at the end of the lane in seconds, and it's there to protect your head on any time you're swimming backstroke or sort of spacing out while you're swimming freestyle. If you ever go into the wall, you're gonna be completely protected. This thing's amazing. All right.
For more information, visit cap7.com.
Hi, I'm Wolf Weigel with Cap 7. There's one more quarter to go in this game. Fourth quarter coming up now.
So just about to get underway here in the fourth quarter. Essentially a 0-0 ball game, all knotted up at 12. And Connecticut College wins the fourth quarter swim off. And we are underway, 8 minutes left. Game number 7 of this tournament, the Mid-Atlantic Water Polo Conference West Region. I'm Mike Shannon for CWPATV.com. Bringing you this free regular season stream, courtesy of Cap 7. That shot deflected by Kyle Jones and goes out of play. Cross tank pass, shot and goal. That's scored by number 12, Mike Gertzik. Opens up our scoring here in the fourth quarter. Camels find themselves on top 13-12. Both of these teams trying to pick up their first victory this weekend. It's been a very physical game so far. Really much so in the first half. Kind of toned down a little bit as the game has progressed. Again, Monmouth in the white caps going right to left on your screen, and Connecticut College in the dark caps going left to right. And that shot will go out of play. So Camels on the counter. Need to separate themselves a little bit. Pass to the center. Double team taken away, and Kyle Jones comes away with it for Monmouth College. Ordinary foul. Stays with the Fighting Scots. Double team coming. Knocks that one out of the hands of the attack. Back the other way. They have numbers. Great pass up ahead. Pump fake and goal. Good execution on the transition from Connecticut College. That goal scored by number 6, Sam Guy. So 14-12 the score. Connecticut College, the 2-goal lead. And a long shot and goal for Monmouth. That's number 15, Tommy Schneider. The absolute laser from the point brings us back to a 1-goal game. Here's another shot and a save made by Kyle Jones. Now looking to go back down the other end. Ordinary foul. Offensive foul called. Pass up ahead. Kyle Jones comes out of the cage to take that one away from the attack. Going to pass this one back. Looking for the centering pass inside, and that one's going to be taken away by the Camels. Transition offense here. Player up ahead. Defense catches up, rising up. Skip shot under the left arm of Kyle Jones. And in for a goal. Scored by number 5, Lucas Verilli. Verilli's first goal of the game. So back to a 2-goal game. And that pass taken away by the Connecticut College defense and given back to Tanner McKellis. Timeout taken. So out of the timeout here for the Fighting Scots. Find themselves down 2 goals to the Camels. Skip shot, save made by Tanner McKellis. referee asking for the ball to come out. As we're getting ready here for, well, it looks like we're going to have another conference with the officials. So it looks like got that all sorted out. We'll have a penalty shot here. Trying to make this a one goal game here. I believe we're just getting it sorted out at the scores table. See on the top of your screen, head coach for Connecticut College, Matt Anderson, having a conversation with official Igor Mernenko. Both gentlemen familiar with each other, possibly just getting an explanation on what's going on here. And it looks like it's going to be a conversation over at the scores table involving the coaches. So they're just trying to sort this whole thing out. So it looks like we got that all sorted out. Going to be a penalty shot. Trying to make it a one-goal game. And he converts. Goal scored for number 20, Joseph Addison. His third goal of the game. First goal of the fourth quarter. Rising up, shot! Goes off Kyle Jones and out of play. Good save by Jones. Jones, a sophomore from Parkland, Florida. And another save made by Kyle Jones. And the defense able to get this one out of harm's way for him. Trying to tie this game up. And it's taken away by the defense. You hear head coach Peter Allis yelling press. Going to have a penalty shot coming up for Connecticut College. And goal scored for the Camels. Goal scored by number 12, Mike Gertzik. Fourth goal of the game. Second goal of the fourth quarter. And he scored all four of those goals in the second half. Skip shot, save made. Connecticut College just trying to kill some time here. Head coach Matt Anderson is excited about that goal. Now scored by number 10, Arturo Freitas. Shot and save made. And we're going to have an exclusion on the play. It's a power play opportunity for Monmouth. This one taken away. Still a race for it. Conn College comes away with it. Another goal scored for Connecticut College. That one scored by number 5, Lucas Verilli. His second goal of the quarter. 6 goals have been scored by Connecticut College in this fourth quarter. Compared to the Monmouth 2. As we entered this quarter, all knotted up at 12. Also, just want to remind you, coming up, Salem versus Gannon. scheduled to start in just 7 minutes here. Let's see if we're going to be keeping on track. So the Tigers against the Golden Knights right here on CWPATV.com. And that will do it. So the final score in this one, Connecticut College 19, Monmouth 14.